Hello everyone, this is Sonia here from Growing Craft and I'm back with my another crafty tutorial on card making. I'm really happy that finally I'll be using my crafty scrapper stamp set Eid Mubarak theme, and I really love the lambs of these, and that's the reason I got them, and these are super cute. As you can see, my background page already has some spray on it, so that's the shimmer spray which I used in my previous project, and this was the page which I kept on my table so that I have a nice background to work for my future projects. I am using another shade of shimmer spray just to add a little more drama to my colors and my background. While stamping, make sure your shimmer spray or the coloring or the background, whatever you have done, has dried out completely. The reason why I wanted to first do the spray paint and then the stamping was that I didn't want it to go for typical coloring work or the shading work. I really wanted to give it more of a natural and a night look. So that's the reason I have done the spraying part first and then the stamping part. And I'm really happy with the way it is looking. I'm going to fussy cut all the lamps. Once I'm done with the fussy cutting, I'm using the same cardstock sheet and use one of the corners of it as my layout for the card. Finally, I decided to use my red color cardstock for the main card sheet. I'm just stitching the edges with the green color ink set. Working on a layout is really important, so I'm just arranging the lamps in a way. I hope it looks good. Let's see. So once I'm done with my layouting, I'm just going to mark the lamp positions with the pencil so that I can put my 3D foam tape on it and stick it accordingly. Adding foam tape is a really good idea to give dimensions to your stamped images or the sentiments. So once I'm done with foam tapes, I'm going to stick my lamps finally on it. Make sure you stick them properly. Now I have my custom made stamp which I got very recently, and I'm again using the same shimmer spray background images for my sentiment. The reason I'm using it is so that I want my card to look like of a complete one theme. Now I'm going to add backing to my sentiment. This I have learned from Rajni Chawla ma'am. She is one of the India's biggest crafter, and she once told me, in fact helped me out with understanding, that giving backing to your layout, to your sentiment, to your stamped image is really, really important, and it is. So after doing the backing, I just realized that I need to fill up the spaces of the corners of my cards. So I'm just stamping the same images or lamp images on my card with the in bronze color, and I'm not doing it with the like complete pressure, as I want it to look a little more faded, just to fill up the background. Once I'm done with the sentiment sticking, I'm going to use a little more of glitter. Like you can see here, I have used my tacky tape. Just put up a, this is actually a very quick and a very nice tip. Just put up your tacky tape and you can stick your glitters on it. Trust me, it really lasts long, and these look really, really cute, and it actually gives a more detailing to your card. Now to my bronze stamped images and to my fussy cut lamps, I'm going to add some glitter on it. So I don't really want to mess up with the detailing of the lamps. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to highlight the borders or the dark lines of my lamps, just to make sure that those points are only highlighted and I do not ruin the beautiful designs of it. Make sure that after applying Fevicol, you stick the glitter really fast as it fevicol dries up little fast, as and it shouldn't look bad actually. So this is how it is going to look. So once my card base is ready, now I'm going to finally stick it on my red card stock. Again, for this I'm using my foam tape to stick it. Like I said, I really like giving dimensions to my cards, to my layouts, to my sentiments. It is really a good way of highlighting your work. Make sure you stick it really nicely. I just realized that I should have added some more foam tape on my backing, but no worries, I could manage with this. So I'll make sure that I don't forget this next time. Just to highlight the lamps, I'm adding red color rhinestones on the top of it, just on the hook of the lamp, so that when I use my pen or pencil for the strings, it looks good. So I tried using it with my watercolor pencil, but it was really, really fade. So then I thought of using my black gel pen and to highlight the strings of my lamp, and I'm really happy with the way it has turned out. I hope you enjoyed this card making tutorial. Please do subscribe to my channel, and if you have any query, feel free to ask me. Comment below. Thank you so much.